Now that we have epoxides and know how to make them, it's important to know what can we do with them. And it turns out that ethers are highly unreactive. Ethers barely react with anything. But because of the fact that epoxides are three-membered rings, they're very, very highly strained. So what that means is that even though ethers as a functional group are not very reactive, epoxides are, because they have so much potential energy locked up in those bonds. They're going to want to break open first chance that they get. So it turns out that we have two different ways that we can open the epoxide ring, and they have to do with different reagents that we use. So these are called the acid-catalyzed ring opening reaction and the base-catalyzed ring opening reaction. Let's start off with acid, and then we'll work on to base, okay? So in an acid-catalyzed reaction, notice first of all that I'm using the words acid-catalyzed, okay? That actually already gives us a hint about the mechanism, okay? Remember what I said, whenever you have an acid-catalyzed mechanism, what's the first step going to be? Protonation. You always need to protonate first, okay? If it says acid-catalyzed, you always need to protonate first. So what that means is that the very first step is that if I'm using an acid with an epoxide, the O, the nucleophilic O, is going to go ahead and grab the H from the acid because that H has a positive charge. So now what I'm going to get is a molecule that looks like this, where everything's still in the same exact place. Okay? Except that I've got a formal charge on this positive, on this O, okay? Because the O has too many bonds. All right? So now what happens? I've got a Cl minus, and the Cl minus wants to break open the ring, but it's trying to decide which side is it going to break. Is it going to break the most substituted, the tertiary, or the least substituted, the secondary? Okay? That's supposed to be a 3, by the way. Let me draw that again. The tertiary or the secondary? And the answer to this is that the chlorine, or whatever anion we're using, even if it was just a neutral nucleophile, is going to be the most attracted to the side of the ring with the most positive character. Okay? So what we're looking at is the side of the ring that could stabilize that carbocation the best. Because that, I just said carbocation, it's not a carbocation, it's just a cation, it's just a positive charge. But that positive charge can delocalize a little bit into those two different atoms. So the question is, which side is going to be the one that has the most positive character, the secondary or the tertiary? The answer is the tertiary. So I'm going to go ahead and attack here, and if I make that bond, I have to break a bond, so I'm going to break the bond to the O. What this is going to give me is a new compound that looks like this. Let's say that this bond right here is the red bond that I'm drawing here. Okay, oops. That red is the same as this. What is it going to have on it? Well, let's say that this chlorine attached from the front, right there. What else would it have? Well, it would have two methyl groups, so I'm going to draw methyl-methyl. Okay? And then, on the other side of the red bond, what am I going to have? Well, if the chlorine attached from the back, what that means is that the alcohol is going to go, from the front, the alcohol is going to go to the back. Okay? By the way, this alcohol that I'm drawing here is just that right there. Notice that it's still attached in this position. Okay? So it's still going to be attached there. All right? On top of that, I'm still going to have two other groups. I'm going to have a propyl, and I'm going to have an H. So that H would just stay where it is in the front. Okay? Obviously, you don't need to draw H's. So at the end of the day, I could have just drawn this without the H. Okay, I could just erase that if I wanted to. Okay? Does that make sense? So notice what my product is here. What my product is that I'm going to get, a nucleophile attaching to the more substituted position. Okay? And I'm going to get an alcohol at the least substituted position. Okay? Just so you guys know, this is unique to acid-catalyzed ring opening. Base-catalyzed ring opening is actually going to be different, okay?